This is Our Lives. I'm Gwen Edwards, fighting injustice in the criminal justice system. The fight continues. My guest today is at the forefront of the bipartisan effort to reform our criminal justice and prison system. Lewis L. Reed is a Bridgeport native, now lives out in California, travels wherever there's a need to fight this good fight.
Yeah, I appreciate you. Thank you for having me on.
All right, talk about the movement and your involvement in it.
I'm the national organizer for hashtag Cut50. Cut50 is a bipartisan criminal justice initiative co-founded by CNN political commentator and now Reform Alliance CEO Van Jones. And we have two very distinct missions. Number one, we want to be able to reduce our criminal justice system in half. And we also want to reduce crime in the United States of America in half. And we are going to do that within the next 10 years.
Now, you had a recent victory with
Several recent victories.
First one I'm talking about is the stay of execution.
That's correct. We have been supporting the Rodney Reed campaign to make sure that there is a very specific stay of execution, just so that there can be a process of justice, so that there can be a re-examination of the facts, and so that we are not going to be putting to death an innocent man.
Also, the criminal justice reform. Mm-hmm.
So the First Step Act is a federal piece of legislation that was passed into effect last December by the Trump administration. It had bipartisan support, bipartisan coalition. It was led by people who are impacted, such as myself. I served nearly 14 years in federal prison, and I never forgot where I came from, in a sense, right? So we believe that those who are closest to the problem are also closest to the solution, but often furthest from resources and power. And so the Federal First Step Act is a reflection of people who have been impacted by the criminal justice system in Washington, making sure that our voices, our stories were told and heard, and ultimately we got a win. What does that win look like? I'm glad that you asked. To date, in less than a year, we have more than 7,000 people who have been released back into our communities as a result of the First Step Act being passed. Let me quantify that for you, Gwen. That has resulted into more than 155,000 years of human freedom back into our communities. Now think about this, Jesus died 2,000 years ago, and we have 155,000 years of human freedom back to our communities. In Connecticut alone, we have 17 people that were released that are back into our communities, 10 of which were serving life sentences.
Quickly, Lewis, give us the website.
You can go to cut50.org, that's www.cut50.org, and or you can follow me on any social media platform at Lewis L. Reed, L-O-U-I-S, the letter L-R-E-E-D.
All right, Lewis, thank you very much for your time.
Thank you so much for having me, thank you.
And we wanna thank you for watching Our Lives, and we hope to see you the next time.